Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to Los Angeles Third Church for Spiritual Living, where we are celebrating and honoring Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you. I received that. Happy Mother's Day, daughter of God. Happy Mother's Day to the wives, to the mothers, to the grandmothers, to the great grandmothers, and nowadays great grandmothers, because you know we got 40-year-old grandmothers now. Aunties, friends, neighbors, servers, and the list goes on and on. There is an unlimited, bountiful harvest of feminine energy circulating in the world in which we live. That nurturing, understanding, compassionate, intuitive, unconditional love, presence, and power of God. For women, it allows us to trust these gifts that are within us even more. And for the men, it allows you to get in touch with and balance the softer side of life. Because media tells you you need to be hard. But in order to balance the spirit of God, you take your strength and your courage, but you balance it with unconditional love and understanding. Amen?
Amen.
It's not about our gender. It's about bringing and lifting all that we are to represent the greatest spiritual beings that God created us to be. Anna Jarvis, back in the 1900s, founder of Mother's Day, she wanted this day to be about a personal acknowledgement and appreciation for mothers. She wanted us to come together with those that have nurtured and loved us and did those things that took us out of our comfort zone. That's a mother. That's that feminine energy working and doing. Because I'm sure we've heard that story about women who can go and lift a car off of their children.
Oh, yes.
Right? We find strength wherever we need it when it comes to our babies, our communities. So we're talking about that power and that strength and that courage and that love that surpasses any and everything that happens in life. So Anna Jarvis wanted to appreciate her mother who made her transition in 1905. And it took Anna about 8 years to finally get Woodrow Wilson, president at the time, 1914, to establish Mother's Day as a national holiday. But all of that time, she worked to get us to remember our mothers, because you know, so often we take good for granted. Because when it comes continuously, we just think it's just a byproduct of living. But we need to appreciate and love one another each and every day. So 1914. But she was dismayed by the time she lived here, because the flower community, the car community, everybody was capitalizing on Mother's Day. And it's absolutely fine to patronize. But we got to remember what's most important, and that is the love that's in our heart and the remembrance of the things that those mothers did. Amen?
Amen.
When I think about mothers, the feminine energy presenting itself in a situation, it made me think about the Trinity. And you know, in the Trinity, it talks about, in the religious terms, it talks about the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. But when we think about that, metaphysically, we're talking about, mind, idea, and expression. Because the Father, the Spirit, the intelligence is the creator of all things. So we first get our ideas of newness, of healing, of wholeness from the Creator. So that's why they say God is mind, not just your spirit, we call it many names. Father, spirit, intelligence, mind, creator. But it's really one that we call by many names, because some of us got many names. So when we're talking about spirit, we're talking about the creator. That's the wrong picture. When we're talking about son, we're talking about daughter as well. Because that's the idea. Because remember, God said, let us make man, speaking of human, in our image and likeness, includes us. So today, we're talking about the daughter, the feminine energy of goodness. And then the Holy Spirit is expression. It is the action of mind, father, spirit, touching. Daughter, son, body, vessel. And when two things come together, there is an action. The Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit in our spiritual movement is about allowing us to open our mind to the omniscience of God. Open our hearts to the love and the joy of God. And allowing our soul to bear witness to the truth that we are the greatest creation that God has made. We marvel at the waves and the ocean. We marvel at the flower and how beautiful it is and how it opens. But do you know you are even greater than that? And we got to stand in that. The Father is our nature. The Creator is our nature. Spirit is our nature. The Holy Spirit is God's word in movement, the working, the moving, and the breathing demonstration of spirit through humanity. It is revelation, that Holy Spirit. It is inspiration, that Holy Spirit. It is guidance, the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the comforter that will bring all things to pass. As we think, so are we. The doctrine of the Trinity is often a stumbling block because we find it difficult to understand how three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, can be one. But it will continue to be a mystery until we dig down deeper. Metaphysically speaking, God is the name of the all-encompassing mind. Christ is the name of the all-loving mind. The Holy Spirit is the all-active manifestation of God. These three aspects are the one. There is but one. You can call it by many names. We are the vessel, the daughter, the son, the flower, the moon. We are the vessels in which the power and the creative idea and the intelligence of God moves through. It needs a vessel to work itself out through us. Everything we see comes from the Creator who touched the mind of the one that was open. Amen. You can't go fishing not expecting to get no fish. You take a rod, you take bait, you're expecting something. When you walk into a center, a synagogue, a temple, a church, you're expecting the word to penetrate, germinate through you, that it opens your mind, that it opens your heart, and that you're able to go about life as God intended, in perfect peace, in harmony. The effect of the Holy Spirit can only be felt when we're open and receptive. The infusion of intelligence, divine ideas, divine wisdom, unconditional love, abundant joy, and peace is only recognized when we're open and receptive. So the divinity of the woman, the feminine energy, the mother, comes alive in each of us when we're open and receptive. And when we're open and receptive, this will bring the nurturing, the understanding, the love, the compassion, the caregiving, and the service that is needed to get through this life, this journey that we're on. So when I thought about it, what came to me is Proverbs 31, 10 through 31, a woman of noble character. Proverbs was written by Solomon, which represents wisdom, and with the help of Argur and Lemuel. Argur represents our understanding, and Lemuel represents for God, belonging to God. So what better way to walk in our life with wisdom and understanding of the world in which we live, and we do whatever we do for God. That's how Proverbs was written. This book was full of wise saying, teachings of how to live spiritual lives through repetition of spiritual thoughts and practices. How do we learn anything by repetition? We continue to repeat. How do you think they train animals? They continuously train them to do this and to do that, and we marvel at a monkey riding a bicycle, but yet not as enthused with the Spirit of God working through us to do all things. The book of Proverbs uses very literal forms, poems, and parables. So we're talking about wisdom, and we're talking about spiritual advice. Proverbs, a woman of noble character. It says this: who can find a virtuous and capable woman? She is more precious than rubies. Her husband can trust her. And it's not just the husband, it is the family, it is the place that she works, the place that she serves. So we're not limiting anything. We are open and receptive to all things that God has to offer. And it says that she has greatly enriched their lives. She brings them good, not harm, all the days of her life. She finds wool and flax and busily spins it. She is like a merchant ship bringing her food from afar. She gets up before dawn to prepare for her household, and she prepares the day's work for her children. She goes to inspect a field, and she don't just go to inspect it, she buys it. With her earnings that she plants as a vineyard, she is energetic and strong, a hard worker. She makes sure her dealings are profitable. Her lamps burn late into the night. Her hands are busy spinning thread, her fingers twisting fiber. She extends a helping hand to the poor and opens her arms to the needy. She has no fear of winter for her household, for everyone has warm clothes. See, mother prepares and gets things ready for her children. She makes her own bedspread. She dresses in fine linen and purple gowns. Her husband is well known at the city gates, where he sits with the other civic leaders. She makes belted linen garments and sashes to sell to the merchants. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without fear for the future. When she speaks, her words are wise, and she gives instructions with kindness. She carefully watches everything in her household and suffers nothing for laziness. Her family blesses and praises her. See, there are many virtuous and capable women in the world, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive, and beauty does not last. But the woman who loves the Lord will be greatly praised. So let us reward her for all she has done. Let her deeds publicly declare her praise. For the mothers that love unconditionally, job well done. See, this book has a lot to say about the divine nature of the woman, the wife, the mother, the sister, the aunt, the feminine presence of the energy of God. And at the end of this book, it shows a portrait of a woman of strong character, great wisdom, many skills, and great compassion. But some of us have mistaken the idea that we are just domestic and that we are just to have children. A mistake. For our service is to this world. See, this book describes the woman of today. She is an excellent daughter of God, wife, mother, friend, aunt, grandmother. But see, she's also a manufacturer, an importer, an author, a manager, a realtor, a counselor, a politic figure, a farmer, a seamstress, a merchant, a teacher, and a speaker, and don't forget, a preacher. Today's woman is all of that. A bag of chips, a peppermint. And the power of God that dwells in the inner sanctuary of our very being. It's the result of our lifeline to the God that wakes us up, that allows us to bear children, to take care of children, even if we didn't bore them. There are mothers that care for the community, that when spirit sends a child their way, they open their arms and they take care. Because it's not about giving birth, it's about love. Yeah. Whatever the question, love is the answer. In a society that adheres to the physical appearance, these scriptures never mention her physical appearance. Because see, my ability, your ability, our ability, and our beauty and our attractiveness comes entirely from our character and our integrity and our moral values. That's where the beauty is. The light of God, the trust and the faith that we carry with us, is what illuminates us, is what radiates us. See, the woman in this chapter has outstanding abilities. Her family is a pillar in the community. Everyone she comes in contact with is touched by her presence, the light of God that's within her, that follows her day to day. So who is this woman? Who is this feminine energy that flows? Could this be the creative woman of God in you, in me? The feminine aspect, the principle of spirit? Oh yes, this woman is you, this woman is me. We are the women of noble character, so let us step into it. Divine love. Divine mother, divine energy. Love yourself so that you can love one another. If you can't find the love within you, how are you going to give it to me? You can't give something that you have not recognized that's within you. I don't care what your experience is. We all got a sad story. That's why we got so many books. Because we need to release. But one day, 1 hour, 1 moment, 1 second, we need to realize that regardless of what my outer experiences have been, I am standing in the image and likeness of a God that will never leave me nor forsake me. So eventually, I've got to stand up in this truth. and give God the glory out of my life. And when I give God the glory, oh my goodness, I can get the victory. Yes. Love God with all of your heart so that that feminine energy of God that was created in each of us, the service that was put in each of us, we all have gifts and talents that God wants us to present to the world. And I don't care what nobody's told you, those gifts and talents are still alive. Waiting on your recognition, see? Yes. Waiting on your unification. Waiting on each of us to realize that I can do it. No excuses. Don't tell me how old you are. Don't tell me what your education was or was not. Don't tell me who left you. Don't tell me who you're looking for. Tell me that I'm ready to stand in my daughtership. I'm ready to stand in my sonship. For the Creator that created me out of His image and likeness, waiting on me to represent the God who I say that I believe in.
All right.
Yeah, we got work to do. And the work is on self. And you can do that wherever you are. You ain't have to drive 2 hours to find your work for yourself. Amen? So we want to walk away with the Optimist Creed. And what it says is, promise yourself to be strong, that nothing can disturb your peace of mind. To talk health, happiness, prosperity to everyone that you meet. To make all your friends feel that there is something special within them. To look at the sunny side of everything and allow your optimism to come true. To think only of the best, to work only the best, and to expect only the best. To embrace only the best. To enjoy only the best. To be just as enthusiastic about the success of others as you are about your own. To forget the mistakes of the past and press on to the greater achievements of the future. To wear a cheerful continuance at all times. Give every living creature you meet a smile. To give so much time to the improvement of yourself that you don't have no time to criticize others. The creed is to be too large for worry, too noble for anger, too strong for fear, and too happy to permit the presence of challenges, diagnoses, people to stop your blessings, your healing, your awakening, the peace that is beyond understanding. This is our creed, to stand up in our truth. There is unconditional love, and that unconditional love you must first have for yourself. Love yourself regardless of whatever you did a moment ago, because this moment right now, you've never experienced it. What you gonna do with it? We gotta stop dragging old baggage. Taking all of your past. And as soon as you meet someone that's going to listen, you start unpacking. Traveling at you and not drown you. Our theme this month is expect, embrace, and enjoy.
All right.
So we need to come here today. It's Mother's Day, and we're spending time with our mothers. I love Mother's Day and Easter and Christmas because I see a lot of my people that I don't see anymore. Feminine energy, have your way.
All right.